What would you do if you were the desperate person in an SHTF situation? Hey guys, I'm Reginald, also known as Dimcat. I want to talk about a situation that we've talked about before, you know, a situation where there's a lack of resources, the grid goes down, the power grid goes down, people don't have access to refrigeration, they don't have access to heat or water or whatever. A lot of the water pump systems obviously rely on electricity, and if the power grid goes down for an extended period of time, people will lose access to water. You know, we talked about bugging in and bugging out, and what would you do in this scenario and that. But, you know, we even talked about, you know, what would you do if people came to you and asked for help, asked for food? But when if you were in a situation where you needed help from other people, how would you approach that? Okay, I was watching this movie called The Blackout, and it's a movie about a situation where the power grid goes down all over. It seems like it's all over the country. Now, in the U.S., we actually have about three power grids. We have a little mini grids as well, but essentially, when I say the power grids, I mean there's a western, out west, California, to Washington State, Montana, all the way over to Colorado and also Arizona and New Mexico, you know, that type of, that interconnection, that grid over there. So what they try to do is they have these substations that distribute the power, and if there is a shortage in one area, they try to make up the difference by getting more energy from another area. But if that system fails, then, you know, that whole western grid could be without electricity for a long period of time. You got the eastern one, as for out east, of course, and it's, I think it's like many ones even out east, but anyway, it's pretty much the eastern one, eastern interconnection. And then you have Texas, which they have their own system. So in this movie, all three sort of went out, or at least it seems like it's a blackout all over New York, major cities, and I think it takes place in sort of like a Midwestern area. I think it's Midwestern, a small town, and you have this couple, a 30-something couple, they're in their 30s, the woman's pregnant, and you also have this one guy who's like a prepper. He's like in his 40s or 50s or whatever. He's got food storage, he hunts, he fish and everything. And then you also have these teenagers, well, these 20-somethings, like there's two couples, these kids, I call them the kids for this little topic. They're about in their early 20s or whatever. And the film shows different perspectives. The prepper is a guy who has his house broken into. These guys warning other people about what's going to go down if the power outage continues. And, you know, so he has to respond to somebody breaking into his place and possibly taking his food, his items. And then you have the kids, the 20-somethings, who are breaking into his house at one point, trying to take his stuff. But they're desperate. They go on this hike. Supposed to be an adventure, but then they realize their car has been destroyed. They don't have access to any resources, any food or anything, so they're pretty much desperate. And then you have the married couple or whatever, the woman's pregnant, and they need help from the prepper guy. He used to be a medic. He was a veteran. He used to be a medic, so he tries to help them out. What really interests me about this movie is that it shows different perspectives. It shows, obviously, you have the marauders in this movie. I'll let you guys check it out yourself. But they show the perspective where the teenagers, well, the 20-somethings, were sort of forced to look for food. And I thought to myself, what if I had to go on a business trip? What if I had to go somewhere to, I don't know, Washington, D.C., which I had to do that one time? What if I had to go to New York? What if I had to go to Dallas or somewhere? I had to fly somewhere far out, and I don't have access to my vehicle and my preps. I'm nowhere near my house, and I can't use my preps. What if I'm in a situation where, you know, something goes down? Maybe there's an EMP and an electromagnetic pulse, and it destroys all, or at least takes down all three power grids, and they're going to be down for maybe weeks, or if not months, right? So I'm in a situation where I'm far away from my apartment or whatever, or my house or whatever. I'm even far away from my regular vehicle. I didn't even drive out there. Typically, I keep water and I keep some emergency food in my vehicle, but when if I'm just, I take the company car and I'm off somewhere else. One of the things you could do in that situation, if you're on a family vacation, if you're driving your own vehicle, obviously you can pack your own food, your own water. If you rent a car, you can still pack, you can still go and carry some bottled water, still carry some emergency food with you. That's something you could do. But what if you just don't have access to that? How would you go about getting resources from other people? Obviously, you're gonna have people stealing from other people, you know, the whole marauder scenario that we see in a lot of these stories. But how would you approach it? You know, I'm thinking, instead of just asking people for food, I think you would actually be more successful if you actually brought something to the table. Like, if you didn't have food, maybe you had something else of value. I don't care if it's matches, I don't care if it's cigarettes, I don't smoke, but still, I don't care if you brought, you know, some other type of resource, ammunition, any type of resource that somebody might be willing to use, even if it's labor. I think when you're approaching people from a position of strength, you're more likely to get what you want. And what I mean by that is, instead of just coming and asking for a handout, why not offer a trade? I'll trade you this for that. In that type of situation, people might be more likely to help you because, you know, if you just ask for a handout, you know, a lot of people may feel like, okay, if I give this person something, then they may come back. They may expect more from me. They may have a sense of entitlement. Then that could be a problem for me and my family, right? So maybe if you approach it as, okay, let me acquire any type of resources, or maybe I'm good with carpentry or something, maybe I can help somebody else out and offer something to that person, and they'll be more likely to do business with me. More like it'll be like a transaction. And plus, if you're coming at people when you're just begging, and I'm not saying people shouldn't help one another, but I'm just saying, you know, you don't know who you're really asking for help. You could be asking somebody for help who has some pretty awful intentions. They may view your situation as, you know, an opportunity for them. They can sort of exploit that situation. They can say, oh, this person's desperate. Let's see what I can get out of this person. That's something you may want to be concerned about. So when you're coming at people for a trade, for example, like say, even if it's labor or something, that's a better way of getting food or trying to get food from people in an SHTF type of situation, in a crisis situation, than just coming up there and just begging for resources. So that might be an option for a lot of people. I want you guys to share your thoughts. What if you're in a situation where you're just completely unprepared? Because you can have all the preps in the world, but if you're on a business trip or you're on a family vacation, you're not going to have access to everything. And if things go down, if there's an attack or whatever, it could be a hacking, a cyber attack, it could be an EMP, electromagnetic pulse, detonated by a terrorist group or maybe another country. It could be a situation where, you know, a solar flare is something where the sun just shoots out a large amount of energy and it fries the electrical grid. I mean, it's something that could happen. So how would you approach bartering and really trying to get resources when if you were in that desperate situation? And I think one of the things also keep in mind is, you know, is how you talk to people, your tone, respect. A lot of people know they're not really strong in this area. So they're used to talking to people any old kind of way. So if there's a situation where they're desperate or a situation where they need something from other people, like food or resources, you know, a lot of people just, they may have a lot of money and they're used to talking to people a certain type of way and getting their way. But in that situation, you know, some people will have to learn to quickly change how they approach other people and how they treat other people. That would be really, really interesting as well, because when crises pop up, a lot of times people don't understand that, hey, I'm no longer in the same position that I was in. So anyway, guys, share your thoughts. Thank you for watching. And don't forget, the future belongs to those who prepare for it today.